What's going on, people? What you're about to see is a pretty raw video of me just walking through my template and some of my thought process for film and television. It's an internal video that was made for people that I onboard as contractors to work with me, and I decided that I would share it with you guys. So hopefully you get something out of that. And it's a stereo template, but the same rules apply to my 5.1 template. The only difference is going to be, obviously, there's 5.1 tracks in there, and then there's two sets of print masters and stem tracks that are made. So you have the 5.1 stems and print master, and you have the down mixes, then you have the actual prints of those down mixes. So check this out, hope it helps. These are the AAF, and I always keep the AAF down here in a folder, and that stays in the session. It never leaves the session, so it always stays in the session. Reason being, if I ever need to go back and pull something, it's very easy to grab it from there. And so here are my track layouts. Everything is organized into folders. Some of them are open already, some of them are closed. So I'll go ahead and open everything up so we can take a look at that. So pretty much what we have is, very top track is my output. This is where my main output goes. Right after that, we have all of my prints. So we got print master, dialogue, music, sound effects, M&E. I always print all that stuff. And usually I will actually have those all in a folder, just to have them easy to button up. So usually name that print, and that goes like that. And until I get to printing, I usually just keep that all closed up. All my reverbs are here. And so I have a workflow of having four reverbs for dialogue, plus an extra special reverb that is just in the template. It's only used on projects that really need a special type of verb. Usually it's like dreams or any type of weird thing that we need some special reverb for, that's not a normal thing. Because you can see here, like the name, the comments on each of these, what I've done is these reverbs have basically small room, medium room, large room, exterior. That's kind of how I keep those. The presets that are on them are set to that. So any scene I'm in, I just can pull those faders up and have that style of reverb. And if I need to make an adjustment to the setting, then I can, but that's just kind of what's going on there. And the same thing applies for SFX and Foley. Same thing, exact same plugins, same routing. Those actually are even grouped to where if I automate on one of them, as far as what the settings are, it's going to automate all of the same plugins. So all of reverb ones are grouped together, reverb two, and so on and so forth. That's what's going on there. Music verb one and two, I don't really do much music verb, so they're only there when I absolutely need to use it. And it's usually more so for tails at the end of scenes or something like that, to where if the composer didn't give a good cutoff or something like that, I use the reverb to kind of enhance that. Or if I need to put something in a space, then I'll use it for that as well. After that, we go down to my dialogue tracks. And so I have a system of four boom tracks that I checkerboard between. Usually A and B are one scene, then C and D are next scene, and then we just go back and forth through that. But if I'm able to just grab a solid boom track for one scene, I might just do all A on that scene, and then the next scene just would be all B if it works out that way. So I kind of jump between those. And then lav A, B, C, and D, same thing. It just corresponds to whatever boom it was on. So if I'm using boom A and B for a scene, and there's two characters in that scene, then it would be lav A and B for that scene, and then the following scene would be lav C and D. This track is just an extract that's just there, just for, you know, whatever. Here's my fill tracks. If I ever need to make some fill for something, like you pull production effects out, or you need to, you know, you place the, if there was ADR or something like that, and I need to put some fill in there, then that's what this track is for. This is just a blanket edit track. It's all, I just use it to where I can just edit. So that track moves around a lot. It doesn't always stay there. It just goes wherever I'm working at the time that I need to make some, do some edits on files. I use that track to do that with. And then we have DXA, DXB, which are just some overflow tracks for something that's not going to be on a boom or a lav. So usually I use those for, like, if it's like somebody in a TV set or random characters just pop out of nowhere and I can't tell if it's a boom or a lav. It's just a way of me to just mentally know what's there. Then a DX Futz track, that's my telephones and all that kind of stuff is going to be on that particular track. And then there is a VCA for all dialogue. So all dialogue grouped together is on that VCA. Next, we have the backgrounds. So all my backgrounds and ambiences. And so I have a cutting system currently that is four tracks A and then four tracks B and then four tracks C. And so again, same thing, similar to dialogue, I'm checkerboarding between scenes. So we'll start A, then we move down to B. A, B, A, B. C is just there if there's ever some overlap or some odd cut-ins that need to have some ambience. I have a set of tracks to put that on without tampering with my normal function of checkerboarding between A and B. So C is just there kind of as a safety net. And then ambience A and B, sometimes I have more than that. Just the template by default just has two ambiences in there. And the way I think about ambiences and backgrounds, background is something that continues throughout the scene. It's something that it's an environment kind of piece. So like room tone, if we're in a room with computers, or the computer sound, anything that's just going to be a continuous blanket, just going to be going the entire scene. There's no dips or cuts in it. It's just a continuous thing that stretches out. And then ambiences are little things that are part of the environment, but they can go in and out. They can change. So for instance, if we're in a coffee shop, things like the espresso machine going off or a blender or something like that, that would be an ambience layer because it's something that's not something that's going to continue throughout the entire scene. It only happens periodically and it can fade in and out that way. So that's kind of what my mentality is for backgrounds and ambiences. Then we have another VCA again for backgrounds is there. Then we get down to SFX, and this is where all the sound effects are going to go, all the hard effects. Now, right now, I don't have any tracks in here because normally I outsource that work. So normally there are effects editors that are doing all my sound effects cutting for me. So I only have those tracks here just to when they, once I get my files from them, they just go drop into that folder and we're good to go. So right after that, I have PFX tracks, and those are pretty self-explanatory. Production effects, anything that came from production, I put that on those particular tracks just to separate them, usually, especially for if we have to do a fully filled M&E on a project, I need to be able to go somewhere to where I know where all of those production effects are already going to be at. After that, we have Foley. So the Foley is, I have it currently up under the sound effects just because that's the way this template was built, but usually I actually do pull it out of this folder and it exists by itself. So you have Foley and by itself. And so that's all the Foley tracks, sound effects. And then very last down here, you have music. So that's a music folder. Right now, again, template has A and B, and then also a music FUTs, which again is just for music that needs to come through speakers, televisions, or anything like that, is going to go there. If I need more music tracks, I'll just make more music tracks. But this is just kind of always a starting point. Especially for a film like this, there's pretty much not a lot of overlap. Like you got music here at the front, and then so that would all be like music A, and then right after that you have another song here, which would go down to music B, and so on and so forth. So it's always just checkerboarding between things, and I only add when I need to have another track because there's an additional overlap for whatever reason. All right, guys, that's my template. Hopefully you got something out of that. I also am possibly considering making this just available for anybody who wants to have it. Let me know if that's something you guys are interested in, and then I'll look at how I may want to distribute that to you. So until next one, peace.